NBA champion Kendrick Perkins to the show. Perk, this is the first time we've seen you since the sudden and tragic passing of Kobe Bryant. How will you remember Kobe?
I mean, where do you start? You know, first of all, like, when you think about Kobe Bryant, you think about the king of mental toughness. You know, Mr. Adversity himself, he always found a way through things. You know, you have a guy that was dealing with a legal issue in Colorado and was still able to get on a plane, come back and play basketball and give people a 40-piece wing dinner. You know, spicy.
Yeah.
Like it wasn't no problem. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And when you think about any other person in that situation, from you, myself, P, Matt, lawyers, doctors, or whatever, maybe we took a leave of absence. Ain't no way we'd have been able to be dealing with that type of situation with our livelihood on the line and come back and, you know, go play and go to work and do it at an extremely high level. First of all, that speaks volumes. That's what I think about when I think about Kobe and that aspect for his Mr. Adversity. You know, he found a way to get through anything. You know, other than that, you look at it, it's almost like his passing was, you know, almost bigger than Michael Jackson, in my opinion. And why I say that, because personally, it touched me, you know, just to say, you know what, man, people keep saying tomorrow's not promised, but the next 60 seconds is not promised. You know, I could leave off this set right now and something could happen to me, and mm-hmm. then, or P or Matt, and I could be hurt and we could all be devastated, or even you, Jay. And when you think about that, it's like, dang, man, life's not promised. Man, I'm beefing his family members I've been beefing with, I haven't talked to. And, you know, you get into the KD situation. And I'm glad that I'm up here on the jump right now with one of my big brothers who raised me in Boston since a young pup. When I came in at 17, Paul took me under his wing from day one. Asked him, I was always rolling with him. We was in the Hummer together. I was at his crib in a basement called Club Shiz, Nick. You know, we was in there cracking. You know what I mean? We was in there popping every day, you know? He, you know what I'm saying? And when you think about it, when I got traded from Boston to Oklahoma City, it felt like it was the worst day of my life because I was leaving my brothers, right? And I get to Oklahoma City, and now I went from being a young 26-year-old little brother to now I'm the vet on the team. And the first person to reach out was KD. And man, we instantly clicked. And I embraced him with open arms, man. He embraced me, and like our brotherhood went to a whole nother level, man. And you know, like all the million great memories that him and I shared, I'm talking about hours of on the phone, you know, to 2-3 in the morning, just talking my life, you know, me and him in the hotel together, you know, in Memphis, man, crying on each other's shoulder before we play the Memphis Grizzlies because it's Mother's Day and we both going through some things on Mother's Day. You know, my mom died when I was 6. He was going through a certain situation with his mother. And those moments that you shared, man, you look back and reflect, and all of a sudden you see this happen to Kobe, and you like, man, come on, man. That little Twitter beef we had wasn't even worth it. And the reason that I went public with it is because for the simple fact that the beef was public. So I'm not a guy that's going to throw stones and hide my hand. I'm not going to send them an apology text. No, I'm going to apologize on Twitter. And I'm going to tell them, man, I love you, dog. I love you, bro. Like, and it's real. Like, I'm sorry for whatever part I played in this. Because I played a part in this, you know. I engaged into this negative behavior that him and I went through. And, you know, as a man, I wanted to cleanse my soul and just know, hey, man, I'm doing the right thing. You know what I mean? And I think, you know, with the passing of Kobe, even me going through the airport today to come here from traveling through Houston, you know, I hate going through TSA. I don't fly private. I hate going through TSA. I can't afford it, first of all. So, you know, I go through TSA, man, and you could just tell everybody in there cool. Usually they make me go to the one where they spin you around or right. They thing spin. But today, dude, like, man, nah, you too big. Come through this. You ain't got to take your shoes off. And I'm like, you know, you could just see that everyone has been touched and everyone wants peace. And, you know, it's just crazy, man, that it had to happen like this. But, you know, me personally, I got two stories that I would like to tell about Kobe. Is that one, I remember when we had beat them in the finals, and I'm in Las Vegas. I don't never go to Vegas, but I'm feeling myself as a champ, as you should be. And I go to Vegas, and I'm sitting outside this spot. I'm getting ready to go to it, the nightlife, and, you know, I see, like, three guys walk by me with suits and, you know, the earplugs or whatever, and they walking fast, and I'm like, dang, that's Secret Service. Is the president here? Then I feel somebody come from behind and bow hug me. And I'm like, hold on, man, what's going on? You know, I'm thinking, you know, I'm about to go sit down in the county or something for a little bit. But it was Kobe Bryant, man. And it was Kobe, man. He like, Perk, what's up, boy? And mind, I tell you, this is my first time ever having a conversation with Kobe. And he like, man, I just wanted to tell you, man. Hey, man, it's all respect. And I tell people this all the time, man. You one of the best post defenders that I ever played against. And I'm like, what? I'm sitting back like, dang, Kobe gave me a compliment. I walked up in the club like, you know what I'm saying? Hey, man, like, I was that dude. I was that dude. Yeah, you heard him.
Bought an extra bottle for that.
You know what I'm saying, man? Yeah, yeah. Kobe came up to me, man. I'm him.
Yeah.
I'm him today. But, you know, and then there was another situation where it goes to show you how great of a guy he was off the court to the competitive nature he had on the court. So I'm in Oklahoma City. I'm in Oklahoma City. I switch out on them on the pick and roll. It's 5 seconds. You know, we're on the defensive end. So, you know, I'm feeling my, let me see it then, Cole. Right, I clap my hands. He hit me with a boo. I stumble in and out of something he hit me with. Stumble, he hit the three. We running back down court. He like, all right, Perk, don't make me tear that other ACL. I'm, you know, but you had to respect it, man. You had to respect it. But, you know, like, oh, you man. Know, at the end of the day, man, it's just like, I just see a change in the world, because I don't know if any of y'all know, but, you know, like, my wife, Vanity, she, they started this thing, this proud group on Mondays, where it's former wives, current NBA wives, ex-wives, and it's like 175 of them on this, I think it's Zeus app, and they pray for Vanessa Bryant and her family, Kobe's whole entire family, the victim's family, for 2 hours.
Yeah.
And when you see that type of stuff, man, you just want to, you know, you see the world healing. And, you know, just to end this, I would like to say, hey, P, I love you as a big brother. Hey, Mac, I appreciate everything you're doing, man. Even though we never really had that talk outside of this, but we was connected through our brother Jack. And I wanted to tell you, man, you're doing great things with that Showtime. That. Man, that's big. And Jay, I've been a big fan of yours and much success. It's all right. It don't take nothing to, you know, to show love and appreciate, right. You can go back to your room. You know what I mean? So I think, you know, that's my effect on Kobe Bryant.
Well said, Perk. Well said. Now, you talked about Kobe doing that In-N-Out move on you. We got to go to our distant replay here. Before we do that, we do have to apologize to Perk here in advance. Roll it, Kathy.
What's going on?
Rachel Nichols, who's out on assignment. I'm joined here by senior writer, NBA senior writer Zach Lowe, Matt Barnes, of course, NBA champion and 2008 Finals MVP Paul Pierce.